Hello everyone, welcome to our online class. Today we discuss a new poem. The name of the poem is Garden Snake. It was written by Muriel L. Sun. So let's go to the poem. I saw a snake and ran away. Some snakes are dangerous, they say. But mother says that kind is good and eats up insects for his food. So the poet is a child. So the poet saw a snake and afraid of that snake and ran away from there. And some snakes are dangerous. He knows that. They say to him, some snakes are dangerous. But mother says that kind is good. The snake which he saw now, that kind of snakes are good. His mother said to him, and they are eating only insects for its food. So don't worry about that snake, his mother said. So when he wiggles in the grass, I will stand aside and watch him pass and tell myself there is no mistake, it is just a harmless garden snake. So next time when that snake is moving, wiggles means the movement of the snake, wiggles is that movement, the zigzag movement of the snake in the grass. So when it is wiggling in the grass, he will stand there and watch it pass. He said to himself, there is no mistake to watch that snake, because that snake is just harmless. It's a garden snake. It eats only insects. So now we can check the question answers. Okay. So the first question, working with the poem, answer the following questions. Pick out the line that suggests that the child is afraid of snakes. In the poem, you can see the line which suggests that the child is afraid of the snake. Which is that line? Yes, there is a first line. I saw a snake and ran away. That line suggests that the child is afraid of the snake. Second question. Which line shows a complete change of the child's attitude towards snakes? Read it aloud. So second question was that first time he fearing. Second name. Which is line suggests that he is not afraid now? I will stand aside and watch him pass. This line suggests that his change of mind. Okay. Third one. But mother says that kind is good. What is mother referring to? Mother says that kind is good. So what the mother is referring to? The mother is referring to garden snake. So let's go to the next question. What is the question there? Find the word that refers to the snake's movement in the grass. Which is that word? We already said the movement of the snake. What is that? Yes, wiggles. You can say that word in that fifth line. Wiggles. Wiggles is the movement. Now let's go to that third one. There are four pairs of rhyming words in the poem. Say them aloud. Four pairs of rhyming words. Which are they? Good, food, pass, grass, away, say, mistake, snake. These are the four rhyming words. Okay, so these are the rhyming words. Now let's go to the next question. A snake has no legs or feet, but it moves very fast. Can you guess how? Discuss in the group. It has no legs or feet, isn't it? How it moves? A snake has no legs or feet, it wiggles on the surface. That's why it moves very fast. So we got that answer, isn't it? So now let's check the last question. What is the last question? Can you recall the word used for a cobra's long sharp teeth? Where did you come across this word first? Did you hear? The cobra's long feet. So okay, long sharp teeth, isn't it? Long sharp teeth. What is that? A cobra's long teeth are called fangs. Fang. So we might have came across this word in National Geographic Channel. Isn't it? Fang. Fangs are the long sharp teeth of a cobra is called fangs. So here we have finished our chapter, and even the question answers also we have discussed. I hope you all understood the poem and these question answers. So you can write down these question answers in your notebook. Okay, if you have any other doubts, you can ask it in the comment box. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Take care. Bye.